My name's Lisa. I live in North London with my son and my daughter. My children go to school locally. My daughter loves to paint. She's very creative, she's very artistic.
Hi, I'm Emma. I'm 14 years old and I live with my mum and my brother in North London. I love to paint and draw. It's my main hobby. I really enjoy it.
We noticed when she was about 11 that her right shoulder was a little bit higher than her left, and eventually I took her to the GP. She was referred, had some x-rays, and we discovered that she had scoliosis. When we had the x-ray, it was actually quite shocking that her scoliosis curve was quite bad, that we hadn't noticed. And I felt quite guilty knowing in the back of my head that I had scoliosis too, and it is hereditary. It brought me back a bit. I myself was diagnosed with scoliosis when I was 12. My scoliosis was never treated, never spoken about, and I was absolutely adamant that I wasn't going to do that to my daughter. She decided, it was her choice, that she would rather have surgery than wear the brace any longer.
I wanted to have my scoliosis fixed, so I decided to have an operation using the Mazor robot. I was nervous about it, but I knew I'd be looked after and I was in good hands.
We spoke to Dr. Malloy. He basically spoke to us about some groundbreaking robotic surgery that was about to happen.
It's amazing to think I was the first in the NHS to be treated by this Mazor robot.
So we here at Stanmore have decided to bring a spinal robot on board into our armamentarium to make sure that we can try to make spinal surgery safer for our patients. And I'm going to show you and introduce you to the first case we did. It was actually a pediatric deformity, so a child deformity.
He felt Emma was a perfect candidate. She had classical scoliosis.
So in the main, there was a left-sided lumbar curvature and a right-sided thoracic curvature in this child. And you can see that the spine should be straight, but of course it's not. It has two bends in it.
Then he explained the entire process of the robotic surgery, what it entailed, the accuracy. It was less invasive. It would cause her less pain. It would be a quicker surgery. It would be much more accurate. They explained that she would have a titanium rod put into her back. Using the robotic arm, it would be, her spine would be attached to the rod using some screws very accurately placed by following a CT scan. So the CT scan was programmed into the robot.
But what the robot enables us to do is to take a scan of this spine either before the operation or in the operation itself, and then plan where the implants are going to go, because essentially that planning software within the robot enables us to see around the corner. That enables us, hopefully, to be able to keep all of our patients safer and to be able to put the implants where we actually wanted them to go. The most important aspect of this robot, really, is that it enables us to plan these screws, and this is what we call an axial view. So you can see that we're trying to actually navigate screws down through these little bony conduits, little channels that we're actually trying to put a screw down through to make sure that we don't breach into what is the spinal canal and therefore damage the spinal cord. And that's probably the most important aspect of enabling technology. We've had spinal navigation here for some time now with an O-arm navigation system. This is a more automated system where the robot will actually put the arm in the complete trajectory as to where we should put the screw. We can also look on the screen and see the screw going in real time, so that actually we can check that the screw is going into the place that we've actually planned. The ability to be able to bring robotics in synergy with navigation, which is a little bit like the satellite navigation in your car, to the operating theatre is relatively new. And that is really because of the fact that there's been a synergy of a navigation system with actually a robotic system, of which now we have both, that enables us to be able to use a tracking device in theatre, but also a planning device beforehand to be able to give us precision guidance as to where we would like to put our screws in. This is the Mazor X Stealth Edition, which enables us to actually do precision robotics, but also brings in the navigation capabilities as well.
We are incredibly happy, thrilled almost, by the outcome of how straight her spine is and the fact that she's probably 3 inches taller now. The care that we've received from the doctors, the nurses, the paediatricians, anaesthetists, everybody has been off the scale of amazing, and have helped her every minute of the entire progress from before to now, and I couldn't thank them enough.
I'm glad I won't have to wear this brace anymore, and I look forward to doing all the things I did before, like trampolining and horse riding. The care I've had at the RNOH has been amazing. I'd like to thank all the doctors and nurses and the robot.